We have here a piano, and this is the kind of piano that Mozart or the young Beethoven would have played. It's a replica of an instrument by a gentleman named Walter, and Walter was also the builder of the instrument that Mozart played, so we're about as close to the horse's mouth as we can get here. Mozart's instrument still exists, right along with his clavichord. It's in the Birth House in Salzburg. Though it's worth saying that the instrument was made in Vienna, and so it's not in its place of origin. The difference, chiefly, is that everything is a lot lighter on this instrument. If you can imagine building a hammered action on the frame of a harpsichord, you've got an idea of what an 18th century piano is like. And this is built according to the South German or Viennese tradition, and that means that the action is slightly different. If you were all actually able to see what I'm doing, I'd show you what it is, but it's not going to make a lot of sense. What it does, though, is it makes articulation particularly prominent, and in the music of Mozart, of course, this is vital. There are no pedals on the instrument, but you can raise the dampers, and you can do that with your right knee. Your left knee takes care of interposing a layer of felt in between the strings and the hammers, which is called a moderator, and it makes the sound very, very light and muffled. Here's a normal sound with the moderator on. It just diffuses the attack. You can imagine, for instance, beginning Beethoven's Opus 31, number 2, on. Like so, and then you go to a very different tone color. One of the things that this instrument does a lot is it changes color depending on how loudly you're playing. I'll give you an example with a chord, a very soft D major chord. Notice how it becomes more brilliant as I play more loudly. These instruments were also built, and I don't know whether this was intentional, but it turns out that above middle C, it sounds a lot like a woodwind instrument. The bass is a little bit reedier. It's very assertive, and you can imagine Mozart's piano concertos, which when they have runs in the bass, this is one way that the piano projected out of the ensemble. What I'd like to do here is play you the Allegro movement of Mozart K330. You'll remember that I played the slow movement on the clavichord a few moments ago. And again, for those of you who are pure enough to appreciate the revised Kuschelt catalog, this could be also be K300H. This is the first movement, the Allegro. Thank you. And there we are.